So I spent last night at Trilby Station, and I've driven now down to Tilpa. It's about an hour's drive down here to Tilpa. And one of the interesting things about this place, there's a memorial to Breaker Morant from the Boer War over there, apparently the only one mentioning Breaker Morant. And it's also got Australia's shortest heritage trail. So join me now as we do the heritage trail. The first one is about the Royal Hotel here behind us, the Tilpa Hotel. It tells the story of a community member who complained to a member of parliament about the fact that the pub was actually a post office. He says in his submission, "The present situation is unsuitable owing to the frequently being drunken men hanging about the premises for days on end, the frequent rows and the annoyance and interruption from the postmaster." Join me now as we go to the second notice, because this is Australia's shortest heritage trail. So this heritage sign is all about the riverboat captain. For 40 years, the Darling River was a highway. The Tilpa saw its share of paddle boats streaming the river and the characters that manned them. 6 foot Tom Johnson was a riverboat man. He was a Scotsman who, along with his brother Adam, began his sailing career in Arctic waters at £1 a year. He came to Australia as a volunteer on the Lioness. When refused permission to go ashore to visit friends from his home, he upended the captain upon his money rolled out, took what he considered to be owed to him in wages and went ashore. So there you go, that's Australia's shortest heritage trail. Well, I didn't do any research to find my way here, but I knew that Lake Menindee and Menindee itself was a place where Burke and Wills came in their expedition in 1860. But they set up a base camp here, and they left a lot of the guys and a lot of the equipment and animals and that sort of stuff here at the camp at Lake Pamamaroo, at Pamamaroo Creek. And here's a plaque to that. And it talks about the balance of the expedition stayed at Pamamaroo for the next year under the command of William Wright, the third in charge, while Burke, Wills, Bray, King, Gray, McDonough, Patton and Dost, Muhammad, and some horses and 16 camels left here and went further north. So then they came to Cooper Creek and the Dig Tree, and they separated again and went further up and into the Gulf. So this is where they had a base camp. Then there's some logistical issues and some communication issues as to what happened then, why this group didn't follow them up and that sort of stuff. But there was a question of communication lines back to Melbourne. So here I am. This is great to be here. Hopefully I might get to camp here. Well, I did get to stay at Lake Pamamaroo, and this is just over the levee wall from where the Burke and Wills base camp was. I think I can see now and understand why they stayed there as long as they did. Why would you want to leave this place?